NordVPN. You heard about it, read about it, and decided to give it a go. It's been on top of the VPN mountain for some time and for sure has its reasons to stay there. So in today's NordVPN tutorial 2025, I'm going to show you step-by-step how it works and how you can use it on a day-to-day basis. First things first, time to pick out which tier best suits your needs. There are a variety of affordable options available with a flexible variety of included features. However, if you're looking for the best price per value, then the premium plan is the way to go. So regardless of which one you go with though, you can get any subscription at an even cheaper price by using the NordVPN coupon code that I've left in the description. Now that you've picked up your subscription and finished checking out, it's time to download and install. NordVPN is available on macOS, Windows, iOS, Android, Android TV, and Apple TV, as well as a console application on Linux. And routers and browser extensions. Since macOS and Windows included all the features I mentioned earlier, we'll be focusing on those in this NordVPN tutorial. You can download it directly from the website by pressing the Download NordVPN button. Once it's all downloaded, simply continue the installation process. This should only take a minute or two and consists of clicking a few Next or Accept buttons. After that's done, the final step is to launch the app and enter your login credentials. That's it. Now you're ready to find out what handy features NordVPN comes with. Of course, the servers are likely what you'll use the most, so let's start there. You can either hit the Quick Connect button and the app will immediately start connecting you to the fastest choice available. The other option is to scroll through the server list or map, then click on your preferred location. Whenever you're ready to switch it up, just repeat this process to change servers. Hey, but the proof is in the pudding, right? So to see how this server switching is able to change your IP address, I suggest using ipleak.net. Enter the website and you'll see if your real IP address is shown or not. As you can see, in my case, the IP is hidden the way it should be as I'm connected to the VPN. All right, now that I've covered how to use NordVPN servers, what different kinds are available and what advantages do they bring? So the standard servers are well suited for just basic use in daily activities and include all the protection and high speed that you need to stay secure. So whether you're surfing through web pages or watching streaming services, the standard servers are a great option. But I know that some of you want to be able to torrent securely and fast, which is why NordVPN has a specialized fleet of P2P optimized servers for the best experience torrenting. Now, if you frequently find yourself running into VPN blocked sites or apps, then the obfuscated servers are a great solution. They're designed to bypass any restrictions by rerouting your traffic and making your connection look like a regular one, even though it's really a VPN. This one can slow your speed a bit, so it's better suited for boosting security rather than heavy duty activities like accessing streaming content. Now, so speaking of security boost, the double VPN servers route your network traffic through not one, but two servers simultaneously for an added layer of protection. For those of you who want to access the Tor network, NordVPN's specialized onion servers get that job done. Just keep in mind they generally run on a slower connection. So all of those features that I've gone over clearly add tons of security and benefits to your daily online life. So keep in mind which ones are a priority for you when selecting your tier. The basic plan is super affordable and comes with a subscription to their high-speed VPN. However, the Plus plan is going to protect your device significantly more thanks to its slew of security features. It's also my favorite option and the one I personally use. This includes Threat Protection Pro, which has strong anti-malware capabilities, an ad and tracker blocker, and a fully functioning password manager. And you can get any of these subscriptions at an even cheaper price by using the NordVPN coupon that I left in the description or simply scan the QR code on screen. For the next part of this NordVPN tutorial 2025, I'll quickly run through all the settings. Under the connection tab, you're gonna find a list of available protocols. For any manual VPN or router connection setup, the OpenVPN TCP or UDP option will be ideal. However, I generally stick with NordLynx as it's the fastest and very stable. Moving on to Auto Connect. As the name suggests, enabling this function means your device will immediately connect to the VPN according to your preset network settings. I really like that it keeps my device protected at all times and even lets me choose which specific server I'd like to connect to. This works hand in hand with the trusted networks function below, which lets users create a list of networks that they trust, so automatically connecting to the VPN won't even be necessary. Now, there are several reasons why I rank NordVPN as one of the best VPN providers on the market, but the fact that it's one of the few out there to come with not one, but two kill switches is high up there. So a kill switch is designed to cut the connection to your network if any VPN instability is detected. The network one works across the board to protect your device, while the app kill switch lets you select which specific apps you'd like internet connection to be cut from in the case of VPN instability. Personally, I whitelisted anything that has my personal data, like social media, email, and banking apps, but left ones like photo editors and news outlets. All right, so keeping with the theme of customizable features, let me show you how to use NordVPN split tunneling. Here you can whitelist which sites or apps you'd like the VPN to not be routed through. So I found this feature to be really convenient as it allows me to do online activities such as watching my favorite foreign streaming services while simultaneously shopping on my local Amazon. Keep in mind, it is available on all operating systems except macOS, iOS, and Apple TV. And if, like me, you often share files and media with other devices but want to do it in a more secure way, then enter MeshNet. This creates a protected connection between multiple devices so you can safely send content or even remotely access the other devices. This was actually perfect whenever I wanted to host video games with all my friends and connect us remotely. So to sum everything up, NordVPN is an overall great tool and brings tons of benefits to your day-to-day life. The basic plan provides you with excellent VPN protection, while the standard plan is very affordable and includes all the top-notch antivirus capabilities that you need to stay safe. But NordVPN offers even more protective features in the complete plan for those seeking that. All right, let me know if you have any more questions about this provider in the comments section, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.